The needs of women held in detention have received little attention and continues to be neglected by health systems and prison authorities. One reason for this is that women prisoners are a clear minority group within prisons all around the world. Hello, everyone. Today I'm going to talk about prison corruption, and I'm going to refer back to Netflix series Orange is the New Black. So, Orange is the New Black is a very popular TV show that came out maybe 2 years ago, and it's based off Piper Kerman's 13-month memoir that she wrote. And it talks about, her memoir talks about how prison is and how she lived through it. So today I'm going to talk about three main problems within prisons. Problem one, drug smuggling. Problem two, sexual misconduct. And problem three, healthcare and mental health care issues. Problem one, drug smuggling. In this clip that I'm going to show you in a few seconds, you will see Nikki, Piper, and Alex within the garden outside of the prison, and they are actually doing crack. They have smuggled crack into the prison and are usually using it for their own benefits. The drug smuggling within prisons has gone out of control. It is an extensive business that happens daily within prisons, and most times there are staffs that help them, or they either find ways to get it in the prison without getting caught. Problem two, sexual misconduct. Sexual misconduct in women prisons is a major concern. Male officers in women prisons have too much authority. Male officers can watch females change, dress, go to the bathroom, and they can even go in their cells while they're sleeping. They have too much space and opportunity to take advantage of the women inmates, and the women inmates can't do anything about it. A major solution to this problem is segregation within women prisons. Have all women correctional officers and no male correctional officers. In this clip that you are seeing right now, you see Officer Mendez at the door, and then you see him call over a woman inmate. He is bribing her and teasing her with a McDonald's breakfast sandwich because she's been in prison so long. And you can't hear it, but he verbally uses inappropriate language towards her. And once she says a comeback, he gets aggravated and says that he will send her to segregation if she doesn't back up off of him. Problem three, healthcare and mental health care for prison inmates. In this clip, you see Lolly, who has a mental breakdown and she wants to travel back in time because she killed someone, and she can't really do that, so she has a mental breakdown. And the only thing that the prison does is send them to psych wards so they can finish out the rest of their sentence in a psych ward. At the end of the video, you see that there's a patient, well, not a patient, an inmate going crazy, and then there's correctional officers trying to hold her down. This is a repeated thing within prisons. Nobody gets better because there's no programs, no counseling, and there's barely any health care within prisons that help mental ill people get back to the, not normal, but get back to a daily function of being okay. Healthcare within prisons are very scarce. They don't have enough resources or money to be able to financially and stably keep all of the prisoners well and healthy. Within prisons, especially women prisons, they don't have a gynecologist on hand. They don't even barely have 2 to 3 doctors on hand because they don't have enough money or resources to give these doctors. So healthcare within prisons. Orange is the New Black is not just a fictional TV show, but it's an insight of the true harsh realities and daily occurrences within prison law. It shows what the women and prisoners do to just survive the sentences. Thanks for watching, guys!